For centuries, families would bring engaged couples to special places to marry. And as you can see, there is natural beauty to this pristine beach, with the mighty ocean rolling towards us, and setting a perfect backdrop as we've gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Ariane and Luke. This is a place of relaxation, peace and leisure. It's a place to restore your own soul and ponder on important things in your life. So it's welcome to the beautiful Crowdy Bay and the marriage of Ariane Pamela Roseblade and Lachlan Terence. My name is Roxanne Rupert, and I'm the celebrant invited to conduct this ceremony for this lovely couple here today, and I'm just one of the many people who make up this their coastal. And I actually happen to live not very far down the road from the Burke family home. It's just one minute. As the friends of and family of Ariane and Lachlan, every one of you make up a kaleidoscope of characters and personalities. You're a blend of people that makes all of their life whole. I understand that each of you have contributed to their lives in many, many ways. Some of you know them through their work and their travels, and some of you are here that have known them since the day they were born. Some of you have spent many wonderful hours with them during your childhood, and some of you simply just know them. You're the people who have watched and supported them through their ups and their downs, embracing them as individuals and as a couple. You're here because of the integral part that you've played in their lives, and for this, they're truly grateful. Lachlan and Ariane feel very proud and deeply appreciate that you're here with them today to celebrate the love they've found with one another. And they've asked me to propose this question to you. Do you, friends and family of Ariane and Lachlan, promise to support them throughout their marriage, and if necessary, remind them of just how wonderful the other is if they ever might forget it?
We do! Thank you,
I say this to each of you gathered, always stand beside them and not between them, and give them your love and your support, not your judgment, because if you can do these things, you will indeed honour the marriage that's commenced today. There are many features to love, and there's been a great deal written about love throughout the ages. Some have drawn it, some have sculptured it, some have painted and some have sung about it. Some have taken risks, all for love. Every one of us here know that love is something that's precious, but it's a word that's quite often used sentimentally without much thought. We sometimes think that love's rare and mystical, when in fact it is our natural state of being. Love is present within us, around us and between us. Sometimes we get caught up in life. There's always things to do and errands to run, and this can take us away from our awareness of the love that's always present. When we love, we see things others don't. When we can see beneath the surface to cause which makes our life special and unique. Some have said that love takes trust to know that you want only the best for one another. That it takes dedication to stay open to one another even when it's difficult to do so. Love's the basis of marriage, and yet marriage is not just a commitment between two loves, it's also an agreement between two friends. Today in this ceremony, Ariane and Lachlan are affirming the love they have for each other in promising to nurture themselves, each other and their marriage. Ladies and gentlemen, I understand that they first met some time ago in their thespian days with the DMS. Lockie tells me that he thought that Ariane was a bit of all right. He thought other things too, but they're not printable. But for Ariane, it was simply platonic, even though she did admire his crazy sense of humour and his personality. But it was at the Glasshouse Uni Bar in 2009 that they eventually met up again.
Yeah.
In fact, yay, it was the 13th of August, known as International Suit Up Day. Maybe the 14th of January should be now. Lockie was there looking very dapper in someone else's jacket. And Ariane was there because she had so many reports and assignments due that she and her friends decided they needed the therapy that the bar provided. Lockie had spotted Ariane on her way to the bar for a drink. He ceased his conversation with her mate immediately and said, "Watch this, it's either going to go really..." to Ariana's slurred. This might sound strange, but did you used to... English is terrible. Did you used to be in the Dural Musical Society? And he was greeted by, oh my God, Lockie, and a giant hug. The rest, they tell me, is history. This is a couple who share a love of many things, particularly their outdoor life. But most important, they share a love for each other. Ariane is the light in Lachlan's life, and he admires her natural beauty and her intellect and her kind heart. He's in awe of the fact that she will give anything a try, and she's confident, she never whinges, and she has a great sense of humour, which is indeed as warped as his. And he also says that due to their age difference and the life expectancy of males and females, he is happy that the law of averages say they should never have to live without the other. But in reality, he just simply loves Ariane for who she is, and he believes that she has helped to make him an even better man. Lachlan is Ariane's strength and her balance as she adores those amazing blue eyes and that wicked sense of humour, along with his honesty and the fact that he makes her laugh. And apparently, he's pretty darn sexy. I think he wrote that piece. He's intelligent, he's huggable, and he's always up to some kind of crazy adventure. Ariane is honoured in the way that he's always treated her so well and admires the way he's not afraid to be himself. And of course, she loves those natural, handsome looks. Ariane is very proud to stand right beside this man as his wife. For Lachlan and Ariane, their relationship has been one of the best things to happen to each of them in their lives so far, and they couldn't imagine their life without the other in them. They're getting married for many, many reasons. Ariane says that she simply wants to keep Lachlan for herself forever. Whereas Lachlan says that he believes that when you finally find someone that will put up with you, you should never let them go. They plan a busy future because there's so much to do and so many things to accomplish, including that microbrewery and continuing to do silly stuff as often as possible right into their old age. For Ariane and Lachlan, their life together is about sharing and embracing all that life can offer. The ups, the downs, the tears, the laughter, and the times when they remember who they are, and those times when sometimes they might forget. Today, we celebrate love in all of its forms, but especially the love that makes a commitment between two people. Marriage is finding the right person who you don't just love right now, but you'll love tomorrow and the next day. Knowing that this person by your side, anything is possible. Making the commitment to marry is not